Introduction. Prior to installation, remove all packaging. There are over 20 different spray booth models. However, the installation process is similar for each model. This video uses the model WLD9200 installation process as an example. There are 11 steps of installing a spray booth. The order of the installation is as follows. 1. Base. 2. Wall. 3. Supporting beams. 4. Air outlet. 5. Light case. 6. Ceiling. 7. Filter frame. 8. Main door. 9. Grids. 10. Air intake and discharge case. 11. Control box. Once the 11 steps are completed, the spray booth will be functional and ready for use. Step 1. Base. Contents. 6 side plate pieces. 1 base frame. 8 base pieces. 6 reinforced flat steel pieces. Place the side plates, base frame, and reinforced flat steel pieces to their assigned positions. Place the screws in position, but do not tighten until each corner is measured and adjusted to be an equal size. Use the iron plate against the lower side of the base to measure the corners. Ensuring each corner is level and straight. Once this is done, tighten all screws. Thank you. Step 2. Wall installation. Place the door frame and the beam with brand logo onto the floor and join them together. Attach the door frame and the beam with the connecting steel plate. Using an electric drill, drill holes and tighten rivets into the door and beam joint. Then attach the reinforced angle iron under the steel plate. There are 6 filter frame pieces. 2 pieces are fixed 30mm under the beam. Both sides of the frame are 555mm long. The size between the frame is 150mm. Drill and affix all rivets, then stand the door frame on the base and fix with screws. Install wallboard, which features the access door using the drill and rivets onto the base. Next, install the wrap border frame on the base. After this, install the other wallboards. The final step is to install the wrap border frame into the wall boards. The inlet wrap border has already been pre-drilled in our workshop. The wrap border just needs to be put in and attached with rivets. Step 3. Supporting beam installation. First, install the 2 pieces of filter frame on the rear wall board. Attach the frame 380mm under the height of the ceiling of the wall board. the distance between the door frame and the filter frame should be equal. There are 8 pieces that are used to form a grid or hash structure. The longer 2 pieces are for both sides wall hanging buckles. The shorter 6 pieces are for the butt joints. To attach the supporting beam, drill a hole between the beam and the wall board, and then tense it with a rivet. Connect the other butt joint pieces with 10cm screws and install them using the same method as above. Step 4. Air outlet installation. The air outlet can be attached using screws into the pre-drilled holes on the supporting beam. The filter frame should be centered over the air outlet opening and attached by drilling rivets into the frame. The air duct cover should be put over the air outlet opening to form a sealed air flue. The duct cover should be attached with rivets and then sealed with glass glue. Light case installation. The light case frame should be attached to both sides of the wall board. Measure 600 mm from the ceiling of the wall board and drill holes, ensuring the holes are level to attach the light box frame. Attach the seal joints to both ends of the light case. The seal joint also aids to enhance the strength of the light case. Attach the light case between the supporting edge and the air outlet duct using the drill and rivets. connect the wire from the light case to the control box. Step 6. Ceiling installation. The ceiling board attaches using a buckle. First, install the pieces of ceiling board by starting from the door panel. Using the drill, tighten rivets over the existing holes in the wall. Seal up all connecting joints on the side panels attaching to the ceiling. Step 7. Filter frame installation. The filter frame and the filter are separate from each other in the package. The filter can be cut to size, depending on how big you wish to have the filter frame. It is attached using screws and should be adjusted until it fits and seals with the frame. Step 8. Main door installation. Attach the three pieces of the main door, pre-made door board, to the door frame. Adjust each gap to equal size. Install the door hinge with a 10 cm screw. Open and close the door to check whether it is flexible and adjust accordingly. Step 9. Grid installation. Install the grade beam cover onto the supporting beam at the base. Attach the base filter net into the slots on each side of the grade beam cover. Place the fiber filter onto the base filter net. The example uses two rows, however, the exact installation would depend on your requirements. Place the grids between the two sides of the grade beam cover. There are two types of grids. One has two rows. The other, grid cover, covers the whole base, depending on the model you are assembling. Step 10. Air intake and discharge case installation. The installation involves the base, case body, burner, exhaust pipe, air intake pipe, horn, joint, and electric actuator. These components are the heaviest and largest parts, so stack the cases of this component together when unloading packages. The burner is a precision component. Prevent vibration when moving the burner. Align the cases to the air inlet sight and connect the booth body. Connect the four sides of the horn joint to the booth body with rivets and seal the joint. Attach the burner to the booth body. Step 11. Control box installation. The control box differs on each model of spray booth. For example, the remote control, touchscreen, inverter, and general controls are all different depending on which model you are using. The user manual contains detailed descriptions of the controls, features, and operational instructions. Now that installation is complete,